Hey, happy day 69 of the BP Challenge. Sharon Horne-Ellstrom here, also known as Pajama Grandma, in my warm and cozy frosty robe fuzzy robe. It's been snowing for like 4 days, where I am snowed over the entire weekend and then some, and it's beautiful. It's beautiful out, but it's cold. It makes me cold just looking out the windows. Frosty, beautiful, white, winter wonderland, Christmas card, perfect time for the season view, but you know, makes you a little shivery sometimes. Thus, the nice warm coffee in my Yellowstone mug. Kids brought it back when they went to Yellowstone this summer for a couple of weeks. But let's talk about where we're at. Today is day 69, which means it's the review of the section that we just finished. This section was all about the basics. So what did we cover? We covered water. We covered the importance of drinking water today. We covered beverages, alcoholic beverages, coffee, caffeinated beverages, the impact they might have on your goal or objective, your 90-day push. For me, it's reducing my blood pressure. And again, as I'm sitting here drinking coffee, a lot of the data and a lot of the research says coffee increases your blood pressure. Well, to me, coffee de-stresses me, and I think I'm testing it, but it reduces my blood pressure. So beverages. We talked about sleep, the importance of sleep. Are you getting enough sleep? How much are you getting? Are you getting enough? Are you getting enough for you? How do you feel in the morning? Are you getting good quality sleep? So we talked about sleep. We talked about the air that we breathe. We talked about breathing, the quick and easy 4x4 technique for reducing stress and being calm. We'll talk about more of that over the next couple of weeks. We also talked about herbs, and we talked about nutrition and choices. We kind of took a day off for the holiday and reminded ourselves that we always have a choice. We can always substitute and make better choices. And that one day won't kill us. If we take one day off of anything, it's not gonna kill us. But if we let that be the slippery slope that we slide down and take on bad habits by taking not one day, but a year off, it's gonna have a bigger impact on us than if we just take one day off here and there. And sometimes we need, depending on what works best for you, you might need a reward day or a day off day for anything. Time off from work, time off from focusing on your goal or objective every single day wholeheartedly, or just a catch-up review day. And we talked about, I said herbs, we talked about different strategies and techniques and methodologies and tools and tactics that we can use to move us toward our goal, meaning things like acupuncture, meditation, biofeedback, NLP, neuro-linguistic programming, tapping, things like that, different modalities, different methods, Reiki, different energy healing, all the kinds of different things that can help us when we're going for a health or wellness goal, when we're going for a lifestyle challenge or change, when we're going for a physical change like me, a blood pressure reduction. I want to get that number down. Or even a business change, because guess what? If we don't have our health, we got nothing. If we're not here to get our business goals or our job goals or our financial goals, if we don't have our health, if we don't take care of ourselves, if we're not doing the things that we have to do, the basic things that we have to do to make sure that we have the energy and bottom line, make sure we have the energy to move toward what we want, nothing's gonna matter. I mean, nothing will shut you down faster than a health challenge, a physical health challenge, either for yourself or somebody you love and care about. So keep that in mind. Keep in mind that we have to cover these basics. We have to take care of ourselves physically, emotionally, spiritually, financially, in all aspects of our life, not just in one or the other. There's many a person that has their finances totally handled that is emotionally or spiritually bankrupt. Can't be bankrupt or have zero in any area of our life, or we're not gonna survive. We just won't survive. So that's what we've covered. That's what we covered over the last section. And now, as you think about and do a quick review of what you've covered in the last 9 days, you want to ask yourself, what are you going to carry forward? So our challenge today is to look at what we've done, look at what we've covered over the last 9 days, and then say, what is the one thing that I'm going to carry forward from now till the end of the challenge? Now, I'll let you know a little secret. If you carry forward each of these things to the end of the challenge, chances are you'll have formed 5 or 6 new habits that you'll continue to do even after the challenge. And my evil plan and intention is to have you pick something that will become a habit and a ritual and just an automatic part of your life that moves you toward every goal and objective that you want moves you toward that big goal and objective in a way that is almost seamless. So for example, I'm picking the 8 glasses of water a day moving forward for a couple of reasons. Number one, it's easy. Number two, water has one of the biggest impacts on everything that we do. It's such a simple thing, but guess what? The vast majority of the population does not do it. The vast majority of the population doesn't consume water, just plain water. So I'm taking water with me. I want to take some of the alternative things with me, but I just know that with the holidays and all the things that are going on right now, I can't necessarily commit to myself that I will do those, that I'll explore acupuncture, or that I will go get a biofeedback session, or that I will go get a massage or something, or I'll find a Reiki healer or an energy healer or somebody to coach me through tapping. Now, could I just look something like that up on YouTube and do it? Yes, but it's easier for me to commit, especially when I know the impact that water has on my life and all the research that I've done, the impact that it has on lowering your blood pressure. So for me, that's the most important thing of all these, and so that's the one thing that I'm going to carry forward. What is the one thing that you're going to carry forward? Your challenge today is just to pick that one thing. I would love if you would share it in the comments below so other people can benefit from the one thing that you're carrying forward. That's why I'm sharing that I'm doing the water thing. I've actually got my glass of water over on the sink, and I've already had 2 glasses of water today, and I'm working on a bottle of water with some, and here's another trick with the water. Why I like the water is I can combine it with other things. This has got some collagen and stuff with it, which helps my joints and helps my inflammation. And if I reduce my inflammation and I help my joints and I feel better, it lowers my blood pressure. So it's win-win. So this is actually my 3rd water today. And coffee doesn't count, but I'm having a big giant coffee the size of my head as well. So I know that water will have a huge impact. I can mix other things with it. So it's win-win-win. So I like to pick things that I can carry forward that give me more than just one benefit. But don't put that pressure on yourself. Just pick one thing. What is one thing from this section of basics that you're going to carry forward and do till the end of the challenge? That's it. If I can help you in any way, if you need help deciding or choosing or figuring out or going through what you've done this week and say, what is something, you know, I don't see anything I want to do from now till the end of the challenge, hit me up. I can help you out with that. Have an amazing day, and I will, of course, be with you tomorrow with our next segment. What's it going to be? Guesses are welcome in the comments below as well. Have an amazing day. It's awesome Monday. Whatever day it is for you, guess what? Every day above ground is an awesome day. So it's awesome whatever day, fill in the blank, today. It's awesome today. All right. Catch you tomorrow.